Robyne, you've done a lot of work with Canadian military members, and we, of course, are in a military community. We have one of the largest military bases in the country right next door in Garrison, Petawawa.
Yes.
Talk about that work with the military, and you have a wonderful example of that sense of belonging that soldiers, particularly going on deployment, they sometimes leave little hints, little messages that help them be resilient.
Yes, and so I have the deepest honor and acknowledgement for our Canadian servicemen and women, and they, the work that they do is so extraordinary, and I'm just so honored to be able to have been helped out in that little tiny way that I've contributed. And so one of the events that I took part in a few years back, I was talking to a group of soldiers, and they had just come home from a deployment, and I was so curious about, like, what do they do next? Like, you just did this big deployment, they had been gone for a pretty long time, between 6 and 9 months, and I was wondering what happens next. So I spoke to this one particular unit, and the first soldier shared with me that what he was looking forward to is that before his deployment, he had painted half of his kitchen. So when he was, now that he's back, he's going to finish painting his kitchen. That's something that he had on the horizon. I spoke to another soldier in that unit, and he shared with me that he had started putting hardwood floor down at his house, but also only got half finished. So later in the day, when I had a chance to chat to their lieutenant, I asked them what that was. And what he said, Jamie, was so transformational. Like, it's so significant in my heart. I remember this so clearly. He said, "Robyne, they leave those as signs of hope for their families, that it just demonstrates that there's work still to be done back home. And they're going to come back home and they're going to get that work done." And then what I asked him next, I said, "Sir, does that mean hope is a choice?" And he said, "Doc, hope is always a choice that we need to choose to make to be hope-filled so we can be of service to others." He said, "We always have to cultivate hope." So when I work with those groups, that's something, again, I just feel so honored to do. And actually, just this morning, I had a chance to work with the Canadian Forces and talking about preparing some of our civilians who are going to be going on deployments to do some of the activities to maintain base life. And that was one of the messages that we talked a lot about, is the fact that we have to protect our own morale and the morale of the people around us. Jamie, there's so much negativity in the news. There's so much negativity. There's so much pessimism. There's just so much anger and fear. It takes a really solid decision and a commitment to being hope-filled right now. But I believe that holding that hope is something that can really guide other people. People need to see examples of people that are being hope-filled, something that we do need to cultivate and foster.
Absolutely. The world needs more positivity. We see that every day on social media, the news, and all of the things that you've just referenced. I want to go back to the military community. Certainly, deployments are a reality in our community, which always leaves a partner, children behind. Yeah. Separation is difficult in the best of times, but when we are forced into small bubbles because we are not to be connecting in larger groups, that makes it even tougher. Do you have any advice for military partners in dealing with these things? And for anyone who is in that situation where there is isolation, such as vulnerable seniors?
Yes, and first of all, I just want to acknowledge there's so many people that know so much more about this than I do, Jamie, but the little bit that I can offer around this is I like to think about it that it's not just the one person in the family unit that deploys, the entire family deploys. Everyone is in it, and it's not just the one person who's away. It's a different experience for the people that are here and the people that are afar, and it's very unique, and I just never want to minimize that it's just one or the other. Both people are having a very complex, parallel experience, but it looks really different. And what I think is just so important when we think about this community is again, really making sure that we're operating from our value systems, right? We make what matters most matter most. We keep things in perspective. I think when I think about these bubbles and these regulations, we need to be trusting the people who know what they need to be doing for us. And I look at just around the corner for you, we have an amazing minister in Ottawa, Dr. Vera. She's giving us some really great leadership right now. There's some amazing powerhouses that are keeping us safe. And I think what we need to think about is we're almost as if we're in this recovery. It's almost like we're in a race, but we don't know, Jamie, if we're on kilometer 5 or if we're on kilometer 25. We don't know where we are here. We have to pace ourselves. We have to take things day at a time. And I do think we need to trust that we're going to figure it out. We're going to get to a place where we're okay. but we don't have to make it look like what everyone else is making it look like. You need to do what's authentic and works for you. And so again, for when I'm thinking about, for example, our seniors, there's a lot of isolation right now. You need to do whatever you need to do to still find a way to connect and feel important and feel that there's value there. And I encourage the little ones, like, this is the best time to pick up the phone and call your loved ones, right? Kids can write cards, send postcards, send a card in the mail to a grandpa. Like, those are those little acts of kindness that you're teaching the next generation on how to be of service to others and how to care about our community members. And, you know, I just think that there's a lot of things we can be doing. I know there's a lot of things we can't be doing right now, but I think if we focus on what we can be doing, we're going to find action items that can help make